excerpt was taken from a Full of Bloom interview with guitarist Adrian Vandenberg. You can listen to more interviews with Adrian at fullofbloom.com or on YouTube. Click the links in the description. So you're the first one in, and then, like you said, Tommy and Rudy came in next, but there wasn't any like, hey, who do you think would be another good guitar player, and should we get Vivian, or did you just hear about Vivian coming in?
Well, it was a little bit of a surprise to me because David never mentioned to me that we were going to be two guitar players. I was kind of assuming because the slide in phase in touring was just with Cozy Powell, John Sykes, David, and the original bass player, you know, so
Neil Murray,
great player, by the way.
Yeah,
fantastic player. So I didn't know, so it was a bit of a surprise, but then I thought, well, you know, Whitesnake, two players, and that's fine too. Vivian is a great player, you know, so it was all fine with me, and I found it really exciting. I've read a couple of one or two weird interviews from Vivian years ago where he was kind of saying, well, you know, Adrian didn't want me in the band, and he was instrumental in getting me out of the band. Well, I wasn't, because as far as I know, we had a great working relationship, and I got on with him fine on the road, because we toured for a year and a half, you know, and I hung out with Vivian, you know, regularly, and never a problem as far as I'm concerned. But, you know, David didn't want to keep working with Vivian because there were, you know, some problems with Vivian's wife at the time. And now he's divorced, so I can mention that. Otherwise, I wouldn't have mentioned that. But that was one thing, you know, and David wanted to write the songs with me and not with Vivian. So I can understand that Vivian wasn't too happy about that. But that was the, you know, in the end, it's David's band, and he calls the shots. And I've always had my own band, so I know what it's like. You shouldn't have too many captains on one ship, you know, and everybody knows it's David's band. So I was just happy to be David's right-hand man, so to speak.
So it was understood that you would be writing the next album with him rather than including others, huh?
Yeah, that was because we started writing on the road already, and that went really smooth here in David's room or my room or even in the dressing room, you know, we're usually working on ideas, and I recorded them. I worked them out on my 4-track recorder in my hotel room, and so we were pretty well prepared with a bunch of the songs when the tour was over. And then I went home to Holland and worked for a couple of weeks on more songs and more music ideas and stuff. And I flew back to David after a couple of weeks, and we started getting the songs together and stuff.
Was there any tension during that tour that ever surfaced?
Not when we were on the road, you know. I can't remember any tension. I remember that when we started rehearsing initially for Slip of the Tongue, the first couple of rehearsals, Vivian was there, and he was just really moody because David wanted to work with me as far as the song goes. And Vivian was really not really very happy, and he was radiating that. And I think that was a very important reason that David decided he didn't want to work in that atmosphere. But on the road, for me, everything was great. You know, we traveled in the bus all together. And, we always had a lot of laughs in the, you know, back on the bus, and I only have great memories of that tour and the atmosphere and the band. You know, everybody got on great together, which was, I know, quite unusual. You know, if you live together for a year and a half, like day in, day out, that's very unusual that you have such a great vibe in the band. And I was under the impression always that the same was the case for Vivian, but I don't know, you know, I can imagine that it must have been frustrating for him when we started recording, rehearsing the Slip of Songs, that he didn't have any songs in there. And obviously he wasn't used to that because with Dio, like you said, you know, he was the guy. We thought he's a great player, you know, and Dio, he was fantastic also. And so I don't know, I'm like a hardcore optimist, and I always try to, and I usually succeed in it, to avoid negative vibes, you know, and sometimes I don't even notice them, you know, if they're there. So yeah,
right. That's
but apparently they were in the rehearsals. So because David picked up on it, you know, yeah, it's just weird that it happened. And with Steve, I had a great time on the Slip of the Tongue tour. Steve and I are still in touch, you know. We became good friends after that.